All right. Thank you, Paul. Well, a little cold and weary, but otherwise in very good shape, considering his nearly two-day ordeal. That is how rescuers described 17-year-old Nicholas Joy this morning, soon after a snowmobiler discovered the missing skier walking along a snowmobile trail a few miles west of Sugarloaf Mountain. Now, before this morning, the teen was last seen at the top of Sugarloaf Sunday afternoon, just before 1. News 8's Steve Minich joins us now live from Farmington with the latest. Steve?
Well, Tracy, we're in front of Franklin Memorial Hospital. This is where rescuers brought Nicholas immediately after he was found this morning at about 9 o'clock. Now, ironically, despite the dozens of rescue workers out searching this morning, the man who eventually found Nicholas was not part of an organized search group, just a snowmobiler out hoping he might help.
I figured I'll come out this way, and if I find him, great. If I could help out with the search, great.
Joe Paul's a Massachusetts fireman with a camp in nearby Salem. After hearing news of the missing teen, he specifically planned his morning snowmobile ride through the remote Caribou Pond area just west of Sugarloaf Mountain.
How was he?
He was good. He was hungry. He was cold. I actually had some food on me, so I gave him some peanuts and some crackers.
We know that he did somehow get out of bounds Sunday afternoon.
But wardens believe Nicholas accidentally skied out of bounds, landing him in serious trouble. However, from there, he played it smart.
He then had the wits enough to make a snow cave, and he stayed there for the night.
Wardens say Nicholas told them he heard snowmobiles yesterday, then this morning found snowshoe tracks, which eventually led him to the trail. And ultimately, Joe Paul, 4 miles from the nearest road.
He was cold. His feet were cold. But for being in the woods for 2 days, he was in great shape.
Doing really good. Yep, he's doing very good.
At Franklin Memorial, the teen's mother says Nicholas will spend one night here before heading home. So grateful, she says, to the many searchers. So relieved this nightmare had such a miraculous ending.
Amazing. 2 days. Two nights, strong, smart, did the right thing. He's awesome.
And by the way, as Nicholas's mother left us, she said she had to quickly go and get him a cheeseburger. And I am going to guess it tasted pretty good. Live in Farmington, Steve Minich, News 8.
And I think you're right about that, Steve. Our complete continuing coverage of this amazing story can be found on our website, WMTW.com. We have posted video on our homepage of the wardens talking about the rescue. We also have a slideshow of the search effort as well as the timeline in the search for the teen. It's all just a click away on our website, WMTW.com.